Marcus Luttrell became known worldwide as the lone survivor of a deadly battle in the mountains of Afghanistan. The 2005 Operation Red Wing ultimately led to the largest loss of life in Navy SEAL history. 2 years later, Luttrell told CBN News that he talked to God while in battle and prayed that he would survive so that the courage of his comrades would not be forgotten. Luttrell wrote about his experience in the New York Times bestseller, Lone Survivor.
I made a promise to my guys when I came to and I crawled inside that mountain. I was just like, hey, you get me out of here and I'll tell everybody how brave these guys fought. I said that. And I was like, I'll get out of here just to do that. I was like, I ain't gonna die out here. No way.
What followed is the focus of the retired Navy SEAL's new book, Service.
Service is your undying, unwavering devotion to God, your family, and your country. That's what service is to me. You know, it's not serving my, you know, it's not about myself. It's about what I can do for them.
Luttrell eventually went back to war in 2006. He spent 6 months in the most dangerous city in the world at the time, Ramadi, Iraq. Instead of remote mountains, Luttrell battled in the brutal maze of urban warfare.
Everything is a hidey hole or, a fighting position or something like that. And then you're dealing with the community. I mean, it's a city. You know what I mean? There's civilians there.
Luttrell fought in Ramadi when the fighting was at its highest intensity. By the time he left, the city had been subdued and one of the greatest victories in the history of U.S. Special Operations Forces.
A woman approached me and she's like, my husband's dead and my boys have been killed. Thank you for being here. And that justified it for me. You know, Americans, we do a lot of things. We go out and help people, you know, in their time of need.
Being a part of that victory, did that help your psyche somewhat?
Yeah, a little bit. Getting back on the horse and getting back over there to prove to myself that, you know, I took a hard hit in Afghanistan, but I still had it. You know, I still had the mental capacity to get things done.
His body, however, told a different story. Luttrell says war tore his body down to the point where he could no longer serve on the front lines.
Guys were having to pick me up and carry me around. I just, you know, wasn't sleeping or anything like that. It was just the pain was getting to me.
His military career had come to an end, but not his story. President Bush awarded him the prestigious Navy Cross for valor. Luttrell also saw his SEAL team members posthumously recognized for their service. His team leader, Lieutenant Michael Murphy, received the nation's highest award for bravery, the Medal of Honor. The Navy Cross went to Petty Officers Matthew Axelson and Danny Dietz.
Luttrell's new season of service involves sharing the stories of his comrades and serving his family. He is now married and the father of two children. He says his wife helped to pull him out of the shadows.
I write a journal to my wife every day. You know, I write her letters and stuff like that. And at the end of it, I say, you know, thank God for you. You know, because he gave you to me. He, you know, when I was in that point in my life when I wasn't in the SEAL teams anymore and I was just kind of trying to figure it out, that, you know, I wasn't looking for a wife, never thought I was going to be married or anything like that. And then next thing you know, bam, there she is.
The retired Navy SEAL hopes his new book helps people better understand what sets those apart who are willing to lay down their lives for a noble cause.
I've been willing to die for any of my teammates. You know, that's the reason our training is the way it is. It's as hard as it is. We have to go through that to make sure we're willing to give it all to preserve our way of life. You know what I mean? If we don't do that, then the terrorists are just going to keep coming in and doing what they do.
Who's the ultimate example of service?
Jesus Christ, right? Yeah. That's an easy answer. I think people who wouldn't even acknowledge that would definitely scream through their head.
Mark Martin, CBN News, Norfolk, Virginia.